Welcome to the Big Joy of Learning with Bijoy G.
Hey folks, this is your host Bijoy. I'm an ERP automation specialist and have been in this field for the last 20 years. There are so many articles and videos on the internet about the VAT Act and its detailed explanations. But I have only seen a very few which covers the accounting of VAT. So I thought it would be useful for my friends if I share my experience on implementation of VAT through an accountant's perspective. I will try to cover all the type of entries that I have come across during my implementation. Thank you.
VAT, VAT, is value-added tax. As the name says, it is the tax levied by the taxation authority on the value added on the product sold. As a businessman, we just collect the tax from the customer and pay to the government. So, it is not an expense for the business. It's just a tax liability as part of duties and taxes payable in the chart of accounts.
Value-added tax is a tax liability of the business on the value added on the goods sold. For a better understanding, if a businessman buys goods for 1,000, sells it for 1,100, and VAT rate is 5%, then the VAT liability of the business is only 5% of 100, that is 5. We will see how this works in the coming slides. A business collects the tax and pays to the government, so it is a personal account representing the tax authority, showing the tax due to or refund due from them. Please note that this is a personal account and not an expense account.
The amount of the VAT is directly collected from the end customer and paid to the government. So, no one escapes from the payment of VAT. Before starting with VAT, let's just quickly understand what difference VAT made from its predecessor. Before VAT, some countries had something called the sales tax. Some countries still have. In this, the tax liability of the supplier was the tax collected by the supplier from the customer on the sales value, that is, if the supplier is selling some goods for 1,000, and the sales tax rate was 5%, then the tax liability of the supplier is 5% of 1,000 equals 50. Further, we'll see what happens to the supplier's tax liability when we calculate this as per VAT with the same tax rate.
As you can see from the example, the sales tax liability of the business is 5% of 1,000, which is 50. We will see in the coming slides how this is affected when it comes to VAT.
Let's see what difference VAT brought to the way of taxation with the same example we referred to for sales tax. Earlier, we were accounting only for sales tax that we were collecting during sales or service. With VAT, we started accounting for tax paid for purchases also. Just on an academic interest, let us try accounting for VAT in one ledger to see how it gets reflected on the payable amount, and let's name the ledger as VAT payable account. Let us consider the same example which we used for understanding the sales tax liability. Since we have to account for tax during purchase also, let us take our purchase value of goods as 600. The VAT paid for this purchase will be 5% of 600, that is, 30. Let's write this as a journal and post in the books of accounts.
We will see the accounting entries of the purchase and sales transactions, assuming that the VAT is at 5%. The journal entry for cash purchase of goods worth 600 with 5% VAT will be purchase account debit 600, VAT payable debit with 5% of 600, that is 30, and crediting cash for 630, the paid amount. Before, while calculating sales tax, we were accounting the full amount of purchase cost without accounting for tax paid by debiting purchase and crediting cash for 630. For the example, we have assumed that the seller has added 400 to the cost of the product, 200 as handling charges and 200 as profit to arrive at the selling price. The journal entry for this cash sale of 1000 with 5% VAT will be cash account debit 1050, the amount received, sales account credit 1000, and VAT payable 50, that is 5% of 1000. So, in our example, we have paid 30 as VAT while purchasing and collected 50 as VAT while selling the goods. After posting the purchases and sales entries to the ledger, the VAT payable as per the ledger will show a payable balance of 20, which is 5% of 400, that is the handling charges of 200 plus the profit of 200, value added by the supplier to arrive at the selling price. This is why the tax payable is called as the value added tax payable. Hope this makes it clear about the concept of VAT and its accounting.
For the purpose of reporting, we will need the details of input VAT, paid along with purchases, expenses and fixed asset purchases separately. So, for ease of this, we will be maintaining separate ledgers for these, input VAT on expenses, input VAT on fixed assets and the normal input VAT paid along with purchase of services or commodities. Similarly, we will have a ledger for the VAT collected along with sales, the output VAT account. We have something called as RCM, which we will be discussing separately.
In the next video, we will see how VAT is accounted in the books of a supplier as well as in the books of a customer. This is Bijoy signing off for now. Until we catch up in the next video, your subscription, likes, shares and comments will be much appreciated. Thank you for your time and have a big joy of learning.